Welcome you all. In this video, I will be explaining about the simulation of thyristor based full bridge rectifier with closed loop control system in MATLAB Simulink. Rectifier. A rectifier is a powertronic device which converts power from AC to DC. There are two types of rectifier, uncontrolled, controlled. In controlled rectifier, we can use open loop control system or closed loop control system. In this video, I will be simulating the current controlled thyristor based full bridge rectifier. Thyristor based full bridge rectifier is shown here. It consists of three legs. And in each leg, there are two thyristors connected in series. A three-phase voltage is connected to the input of the rectifier, and the output of the rectifier is connected to a load. Let us see how we can simulate this using MATLAB Simulink tool. In MATLAB window, go to Home tab, click Simulink Library. Once the library is open, click this icon to create a new model. The model page will open as shown. Rectifier is inbuilt model is available in MATLAB. For that, Simulink, go to Simscape, Sim Power Systems, Specialized Technology, Power Electronics. There we can find Universal Bridge. Drag and drop it in the model page. I am renaming it as Full Bridge Rectifier. Then for three phase voltage in Sim Power Systems, Specialized Technology, go to Electrical Sources, there three phase source, drag and drop it in the model page. And connecting it to the rectifier. Then I'm going to use resistive load. So for that, Sim Power Systems in Specialized Technology, go to Elements, Series RLC branch, drag and drop it in the model page. Control R to rotate. Double click the series RLC branch, branch type, I'm changing it to R, and I'm going to use a resistance of 1 ohms. I'm renaming it as R. Then we need a smoothing reactor. So for that, series RLC branch, drag and drop it, double click. And branch type select L. I'm going to use 0.5 millihenry, 0.5 henry. Rename it as L. Then we need a current measurement block. Go to measurements, current measurement, drag and drop it in the model page. Then connect R, L and measurement block as shown. Then we need to design control system for generating pulse to the full bridge rectifier. So for that, Simulink, commonly used blocks, input port, drag and drop it. I'm renaming it as IDC. Then we need reference, current reference. So for that, second input port, I'm renaming it as IDC ref. Then we have to get the error. So for that, in Simulink commonly used blocks, we can find some block, drag and drop it in the model page, then connect. So IDC reference minus IDC actual. So IDC reference minus IDC actual I have done. Then I'm going to use PI controller. So for that, go to Simulink. There in discrete, we can find PID controller, drag and drop it. I'm giving the error to the PI controller. So controller type, change it to PI. Sample time, I'm going to use 50 microseconds. Then KP, I'm going to use 1.0989 and KI 91.575. This values you can use as per your design requirements. Then PID advanced, limit output. So upper limit, I am giving it as 175 degree. We are going to calculate alpha, that is fire triggering angle. So minimum lower and giving it as 30 degrees. Then click OK. Then once we have to here the angle is calculated, that should be subtracted with 180 degrees to get alpha. Commonly used blocks, drag and drop a constant block. So 180 degree minus the angle, conduction angle, gives the alpha order. The conduction angle is calculated by this PID controller based on the error. Then alpha is calculated, take an output port, connect it here. So I am renaming it as alpha order. Select these blocks, right click, create subsystem from selection. Renaming it as alpha order. So based upon the actual current and the reference current, the alpha order is generated. So from this alpha order, we have to generate firing pulse for these thyristors. So for that, in Sim Power Systems, go to Specialized Technology, Control and Measurement, Pulse and Signal Generator. So there we can find a pulse generator for thyristor 6 pulse. Drag and drop it in the model page. Give a alpha. to the firing pulse generator. Then we need, if you see, if you double click this block, it shows, it gives the help menu. So here another input we have to give, that is angle in radians of phase A of the input voltage. So for that we have to measure the input voltage. So go to measurement block, measurements. There we can find voltage measurement, drag and drop it. Only phase A is required. So I'm going to calculate, I'm going to measure phase A voltage with respect to ground. So go to elements. There we can find ground, drag and drop it. So phase A voltage is calculated, is measured. So we need a PLL block to calculate the angle in radians. So for that, specialized technology, control and measurement, PLL. PLL single phase is available. So click it. Angle which is required, that is available as an output from PLL block, connected to the pulse generator block. Then input to that, give it here. Then this pulse, we can give it to the full bridge rectifier. So now we have to measure, we have to give this actual current to the alpha generator block and the reference. So go to commonly signal routing. So there we can find go to block. Drag and drop it, connect it to the current measurement block. Here renaming it as IDC. So format, I don't want the block name, so I have removed it. So from block, I'm connecting it to the alpha order. So then take a constant block. So initially I am giving 300 amps. I want at the DC link. So this is reference current. Okay, then this another frequency it is also generating, the PLL is generating frequency also. So I don't want that input. So for that we can use a terminator block. In the search you click terminator, yes. So drag and drop it in the model page, connect it. I don't want the name of this block, so right click, format, hide name. And this, the user can manually can block the pulses or enable the pulses. For that this option is given, but I'm not going to use this. So for that go to commonly used blocks. There can we can find ground signal. So right click, I'm hiding the name of this block. Then I am connecting here. Yes. So now the model is ready. Now we have to, before that we have to set the input voltage. So three phase, phase to phase RMS voltage, I am giving 440 volt, 50 hertz. So here base voltage 440, click OK. So now the model is ready. So before running, before executing, we have to keep the block power GUI. So for that, Simscape, Sim Power Systems, specialized technology. There we can find power GUI. Drag and drop it in the model place. Double click. Configure parameters. Change the simulation type to discrete. Let it be 50 microseconds. Click OK. OK. Yes. Now the model is ready. To see the plots, we need scope block. So for that, go to Simulink, commonly used blocks. There we can find scope. Drag and drop it. So click, connect it to the current measurement block, which shows the IDC, that is the current in DC link, output of the rectifier. So now let us simulate the model. The model is getting compiled. So simulation end time I have kept 10 seconds. So current reference I'm giving 300 amps. So our system, the full bridge rectifier, has to produce 300 amps at the load, at the output terminal. Yes, the model is simulated. Let us see the waveform. Yes, it is producing 300. So for this, one more, before running the model, go to settings, go to history, remove this option, limit data points to last, close the scope. So I'm going to see the alpha triggering angle also I want to see. So I'm keeping a one more scope block to see, to plot the alpha order. So I'm going to run the model. The model is getting executed. Yes. Now we can see the plots. So click auto scale. Yes. The current at the output of the rectifier is 300 amps. And the alpha order, that is firing angle, is 58 degree. So now I'm going to change the reference. Let us say 50 amps I want at the output. So I'm giving a reference as 50 amps. I'm going to run the model once again. Yes, the model is simulated. Let us see the waveforms. Yes, the rectifier output current is 50 amps. The thyristor based full bridge rectifier with current control, that is closed loop, is simulated as I have shown. Thank you for watching. In next videos, I will be explaining about SPWM and SVPWM based inverters. Thank you.